When the protests hit their peak, the Department of Homeland Security was incredibly visible in our city. I mean, they had the agents in the streets, they were guarding the federal buildings, they were detaining people in unmarked minivans and going viral for doing so. But according to one report, they were possibly also working invisibly. The website The Nation reported last month that while DHS was on the ground, they were also tapping the phones of protesters without approval from a judge. And not just the protesters who were lighting the fires, but the peaceful ones, holding signs and chanting long before sundown. Four Oregon lawmakers sent a letter to DHS asking for classified documents to be released after accusations that agents illegally spied on protesters in Portland by tapping their cell phones, tracking their movements, and listening to their calls. It broke in a story by The Nation and reporter Ken Klippenstein.
Within DHS right now, there's a lot of anxiety over what was done to demonstrators' phone communications. And what I was told is that there were intercepted not just the metadata of it, that is, you know, who is speaking to whom, but also the contents of those calls in order to map out a hierarchy, which again presupposes that there is a hierarchy. I think you're right. You know, that's something that you want to try to find out. But, you know, what the folks told me is, you know, if we want to try to find a hierarchy, and they're saying, you know, let's do this the right way. So, you know, when we collect these things, we're able to, you know, present it in front of a court of law or whatever it may be, which you can't do if you've gone around the formal channel.
The people who are your sources are former agents with these departments, intelligence officers, who you describe as familiar with the matter. Can you explain how someone who is a former person with these would have knowledge of things that are currently happening within something that's considered a very, you know, high security intelligence operation where leaks are just that, you know, things that aren't supposed to be happening?
Well, when you have a former official, as I note in the story, that doesn't mean that, you know, they've been former for a very long time. In the case of one of those two sources, they worked under Brian Murphy, the Undersecretary of Intelligence for Department of Homeland Security. And so in many cases, they can have, you know, very recent insight. And in addition to that, just because they have left one department doesn't mean that they're not still, you know, people with security clearances and in the intelligence community, in which case all of these components, you know, very often will work together with each other, share information.
If you're wondering why you recognize the name Brian Murphy as one of his sources' former bosses, it's because he's the former DHS agent who was demoted before filing a whistleblower complaint where he said officials were telling him not to file reports on Russia or white supremacy.
I don't want to make this too partisan. I mean, a lot of these problems predate the present administration, but in certain respects, it's intensified since then. So for example, there have been analysts out of Department of Homeland Security saying that they've had problems tracking far-right extremist groups, white supremacist groups prior to the Trump administration, but their difficulties, it seems, have only grown in recent years. And all this came to a head in the deployment to Portland of a lot of DHS assets, along with Justice Department assets to respond to the civil unrest there. And the impression I'm getting from people on the inside is that there's anxiety about if Congress ends up investigating this and subpoenaing people, where are people going to fall? They're not actually taking issue with the concept of, you know, intercepting phone calls and signals intelligence, as it's called in the intelligence world. They're not taking issue with that in itself. They're taking issue with that they don't feel as though there was the appropriate legal justification to do so.
Now, DHS has not commented about these accusations. I asked Multnomah County DA Mike Schmidt what he thought about the claims, and he called them disturbing, but also said that we should wait and see the documentation that emerges after lawmakers apply some pressure. Unfortunately, there is no timeline for when that might happen.